You know, people really do know, even though we're in this, you know, electronic age where everybody's, you know, tweeting and all the time, people really do know that there is a loss of connection and that there is a deeper reason for being in the world.
Are you in love?
No.
Unfortunately not.
No. Very much so.
No. Yeah.
Do you know what love is?
I think so.
I mean, it depends on what you mean by love.
Then after this is all life is about. So love is the music.
Having that person that makes you feel safe. Entirely. I think when I do fall in love, then I will obviously.
I think you know what love is when you lose it. When you realise what you've lost.
I hope so.
I do know what love is. It's not just a feeling. It's also a commitment you would make, like, every day you choose to love, as well as be like,
Hey, you're stitching me up.
In an ever-changing world, ideologies and themes are expressed everywhere. From the world of politics to the feeling of anger and sadness, the one common denominator, the universal basis of human life, is love.
Oh, hi.
Who is it?
Love encompasses a range of strong and positive emotional and mental states, from the most sublime virtue or good habit, the deepest interpersonal affection, to the simplest pleasure. However, today love is evolving. Love has become text messages and phone calls. Love is no longer the pure innocence of feeling butterflies and nerves around someone special, but that of Instagram and stardom. Love today is crawling back to someone who hurt you and unintentionally exerting codependency to tackle the idea of forever being alone. Or is it?
How did we meet?
Yeah.
I was 16, hanging out on the street corners, drinking alcohol.
You were such a catch. I was out with my friends, and one of my friends would wolf whistle. And every male that went past, she just decided to wolf whistle, and he followed me.
Not like a stalker.
Well, just a bit.
Oof. It depends which one you class as our first date.
Our first day, I'd say we sat in a field and we played a game where we guessed.
Actors.
We said two actors from a film.
Yeah.
And then we guessed. We had to figure out the film from that. And then we bought socks together.
And we went in the baby section of Primark.
Oh yeah.
Because we were so young, it was probably the Wimpy.
We went to the Wimpy.
Burger and chips.
Yeah, so because as Neil said, I was 14 and Neil was 16, so it was kind of, you couldn't really go to the pub or sort of do anything like that, so we went and had burger and chips.
Although she's kind, she's the most gentle person you'll ever meet in your life. She cares about people more than anyone else, and I just love everyone about her.
With Ollie, I think it's the fact that if you need him, he's going to be there, and like he's such a good listener, and like there'll be so many times where I just need to like rant and he'll just be listening and just there for me.
So why did you start with that?
Oof, well, we were really far apart from each other, and it was just a case of I didn't get to see her that often. Whenever we did get to see each other, I was always thinking, I'm going to have to leave in a couple of days. I don't know when I'm actually going to be able to see her again. And it was just horrible having to do that over and over again. And I thought that, I suppose, I would be saving us two more hurt from breaking up with her, because it was just too horrible every single time and it would just make us both upset.
Why do you think Ollie split up with you?
Oh God, I think because the distance and COVID, and because we'd always been kind of like long distance, we lived like an hour or so away from each other, and I feel like that was always hard for us being on FaceTime and everything like that. And I feel like every time we'd meet up, we'd be together, it'd be great, and then we'd have to leave, and it was like kind of heartbreaking for both of us. So but like from my point of view, I think it was because COVID and long distance got too much, and because like I was in a bad state as well from it, like I couldn't cope with it either. But I feel like he's the one that kind of was like, I can't do this anymore.
It's definitely made us stronger, but I do regret it, absolutely. I think that there's definitely things that I could have gone about it better. I feel like if we just, you know, had a break rather than actually breaking up, we could have had the same thing, but without a lot. And I really regret how I did things as well, and the way I went about things afterwards, because it was, you know, the worst side of me came out, outside me that I didn't really know existed until that happened, until I was put myself in that position.
I think to start with, like, I was completely like distraught. Like I couldn't handle it for the first like month or so, and more. Like I was just crying like the entire time, and like in my bed would have my side and Ollie's side, and I like would not go near that side because that was his, and I'd like start crying. So like, at the start it was really, really rough. And then like after I reached out to him and messaged, I was like, look, I've got stuff I need to get off my chest, because the breakup was so like abrupt. It was literally like overnight or less than. And then once I got stuff off my chest, it became slightly easier, because I felt like I like opened up about what I felt, and he did the same.
I didn't really transition from going, I suppose I did transition from being with or to being alone, but it was so quick. I literally just isolated myself and shut everything off. I suppose that was again one of the reasons why I then knew that I needed to have Ola back in my life, because I shut myself off completely, and if by myself I was just thinking all the time that I missed her and I wanted her. You know, obviously in the back of my mind I was thinking those things, I didn't let myself say them or think them properly, but in the back of my mind, but I knew that's all I wanted.
With the lockdown and everything, like being in the house all the time, he was in London with his mates and everything, and I was actually stuck at home with like ghosts and shit. But yeah. Ah! Oh.
Do you think the breakup was
slowing
down for Ollie?
Can I recut myself?
You can.
I knew when I was alone that I wanted her back, and I suppose that was one of the biggest reasons, again, why, you know, when did I ended up reaching out to her. How I essentially abandoned Ola is what I did. I abandoned her, and I didn't talk to her after I broke up with her. And I can't tell you how much I regret not talking to her in that time, because a lot of things that happened wouldn't have happened if I stayed and I talked to her.
Did the doubts and pressures that everyone else gave you ever give yourself any doubts about each other, or did it like solidify your relationship?
Yeah, definitely.
We're only together to prove they're wrong. We can't stand each other. Just when Avril died, we can then split up, can't we?
Yeah, there you go.
So it kind of leads to, what advice would you give to new couples today in today's society to have such like a successful relationship that you two have got?
Probably that. Isn't it? Like, respect somebody. And I think that's what I say, love is like a multitude of things. It's not just one thing. And respect is probably one of the biggest parts of that.
Don't take each other for granted.
Definitely don't. And don't sort of just become like, oh, it's okay, we're married, it's fine. Still try and keep each other excited and sort of happy to see each other and things like that.
yeah.